You may be wondering why your query fails without an error. Learn all about it this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Bob Ward. Bob, thanks so much for coming on again.
Great to be back again.
Awesome to have you. And today, we're going to be kicking off a mini-series called SQL Server 2022 Hidden Gems. Now, tell me a little bit about what this is.
Well, Anna, you know, for almost like 2 years, I've been talking about SQL Server 2022 and all its great capabilities. But what I decided to do was go after the product shipped and find things that maybe didn't make the marketing headlines, the press headlines, and talk to some of the engineers. What did you put into the product that maybe seem a little more advanced but could really help customers? So that was the idea, hidden gems, things hidden in the product that are actually great things. So
fair enough. I'm looking forward to it. So I think the first one is to kind of answer this question of like, why would a query fail with no error?
It seems weird to ask that question. Uh-huh. Like, if a query fails, I'll always get an error, right?
Right.
Not exactly. So let me show you.
Okay.
Something we put in the product is pretty cool.
All right.
It's kind of advanced, but it's okay. So let's say you have an application that submits a query to the engine. Now, the way this works, we use the tabular data stream to send the query over, and a worker thread picks up the query. Now, what if somehow that the application tried to cancel while the query is running or blocked? We call that an attention. You can't send that attention to this worker thread because it's busy doing something with the query, right? So we do something called an out-of-band attention packet to the engine. It's picked up by a separate worker thread. And here's our problem. Customers, or us, wanted to know, if this occurs, what was the query doing at the time of the attention?
Okay.
Because you don't know if it's blocked,
right,
or is it running, or what's it doing? Unless you do some really detailed tracing of your engine. So Robert Dorr, my friend at Microsoft, I've been in almost Microsoft as long as I have, he built in the product a new X event called Query Abort. So at the time this occurs, he will fire this event if you selected an X event. He will start a timer for the attention, and it'll mark the query as aborted. Now, what happens is this query checks to see should it be aborted when it's running or blocking every once in a while. And if it does, it will fire an attention event. But here's the thing. Notice the attention event is fired after the query aborts. So we don't know the context of the query at the time this attention occurred. So Bob put in this query abort event, which is pretty cool. This is good for like a cancel or a query timeout. What about like a kill scenario? Like somebody, an admin comes in and kills a session based on one of these queries at the same time. Same thing, Bob will fire the query abort event for the kill, mark it be aborted, and close the session. So again, the whole concept is that can I find the context of what the query is doing at the time this occurs, because there's really no error here.
Right.
Otherwise, I have to do some really detailed tracing. You want to see it?
Yes.
Okay, it's going to be a little advanced. Is that okay?
Yeah, I'll pay attention.
All right, okay, so here, no, you know SQL really well, but I'm going to use kind of things like call stacks here,
okay.
So I'm just going to go a little rogue on you. So okay, by the way, great example of a query that's terrible. You're doing this cross-join across these system tables, so it's going to take forever. So I'm going to run it, and then I'm going to go cancel it in Management Studio. Now here's this query abort event. Now today, it's a little more detailed to find the context. We're going to use something called a call stack. You can see in here, though, at least I have the query. I knew what the input buffer was at the time. Now I'm going to use something called the SQL call stack resolver. Our great friend Arvind built this tool. So even if you're not a deep debugging expert, you're going to get rich context out of this. This is free to download. It's easy to do. The symbols are available. I'm going to paste in this call stack, and then I'm going to go look at what is this query doing, or what is this thread doing. Now notice here, when this comes in here, that this is that separate worker thread picking up the out of band attention packet, and it's producing that event. Well, that still doesn't give us the context of the query, which is why we have something called the task call stack. So let me go pull that up in the debugger or the call stack resolver tool. Now, I'm not using a debugger. This doesn't cost you anything. It's not expensive to do this. I'm doing this offline from the engine itself. I'll paste it in here. Now, you might not recognize these function sequences, Anna, but notice it's not waiting. It's not like waiting at the top of the call stack. And you see these things called like scan hashes.
Sure.
It's like a massive hash join that's going
okay.
on. So I know just by looking at this that the query is probably in a running state, a really long one that's poorly written, and I can go find context to go solve it after the fact. So that's the first scenario.
Okay.
Now, notice the attention here that if you go look at its call stack, I don't have any context here. I'll show what it looks like here. Because remember, this is what gets fired after the query has been aborted. And if you look at it, it just simply is going to show us, let me drill in here a little bit. It's just going to say, hey, it was running a command and then it had an attention. So I have no context of what was happening on.
Gotcha.
Great, rich information. So another scenario is blocking. Because that was like a long-running query that had a cancel. A common scenario for blocking is a query timeout. So I'm going to set up a transaction, and then in here, I'm going to just go run a query and set a timeout for like 2 seconds. It's going to block and then time out. Mm-hmm. So this happens all the time in apps, right? But where's the failure? You don't know. So with the query abort, I get the same context. Now, I'm not going to look at that original call stack. I'm going to look at the task call stack to show you the difference between something running all the time and something that was blocking. So let's go back, use our tool again, paste it in, and let me show the difference. And Anna, again, you don't have to be a deep debugging expert to recognize some of these names, like lock, owner, sleep.
Right,
got it. I'm waiting on a lock. So now I know in this context that the timeout occurred because there was a blocking problem. Now imagine you trying to do this yourself. You have to go trace all the queries in your system, run all these different diagnostics, see was there a blocking problem, when did the attention occur, and so forth. Sequencing all that together is hard. With a single X event now, I can do this in a matter of seconds.
Wow. This is pretty powerful. And like you said, like you don't have to be a super expert to be able to figure out what's going on here.
Exactly. Yeah.
This kind of opens up like a new door of visibility.
And it's just, the whole idea is just to make things quicker for you to solve a problem. Why did my query fail without an error? And Anna, it's in the cloud too.
Oh, so this is in SQL Server 2022.
And in Azure SQL, yeah.
Amazing.
Pretty neat.
Awesome.
Because you can't do X event in Azure SQL.
Right, yeah. Right. Okay, cool.
Yeah. What
awesome.
Do you think? This is a hidden gem, right?
I think it's certainly a hidden gem. I'd never heard of it. So it's been in since 2022.
Yes, it has.
And it's in the cloud. Okay, exactly. Any tips for folks as they get started with it?
Yeah, I mean, try to learn how to use a SQL call stack resolver. It's not that hard to download and use. And don't be afraid to look at these call stack names. You may not recognize them easily, but I've shown you the difference between one that is running and one that is blocking. That alone should give you context of going trying to figure out what was this problem in the first place.
Yeah, and from our Azure SQL for Beginners so long ago, this was like a big thing to first figure out.
Exactly, yeah.
Amazing, awesome. Yeah. Well, Bob, thanks so much. I learned a lot. I think our viewers probably learned a lot too. If you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment, and let us know if you've used this and how it's gone for you. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.